I remember you had at that time advocated a policy of self-reliance. Are you happy the way we have gone in that direction so far? Because we are still relying very heavily on import of aircraft.
No, I think our effort has been actually, see, a comparison of, you can say, ability to introduce things is much better. And we had HAL, we have all the ordnance factories, there are about 70 in the country. They are producing things for the defense forces. Pakistan has one or two factories, and they have no aircraft industry at all. So there's no really comparison, you know. In our case, we are. And Pakistan suffers from one thing. They don't have depth. Depth means that Pakistan, they can't fall back on other part of Pakistan, which can't be attacked.
Pakistan doesn't have the strategic depth, as they say.
Yeah, that's right. That's a big handicap with Pakistan. Now, Pakistan is now incapable of taking us, our country.
You said Pakistan is incapable of taking us on.
Is incapable.
Very heartening to hear that. The last aircraft you flew was the MiG-21. That aircraft is still in service. In fact, it is the cause of a lot of accidents. Do you think it is time to phase out the MiG-21?
Now, it is, one got to confess, it's old aircraft. Sometime accident may be occurring because of age. But I don't know, you see. Those are the details which serving people to know.
You had emphasized quite a lot on training. You set up the Hyderabad Training Academy also. But things haven't moved very much in that direction. We've been struggling with the advanced jet trainer for many years.
I think we took a long time to take a decision. That I agree with. I don't know what the reasons were. And also I think, talking about the trainer, we did produce one good Surya, Kiran trainer, produced by HAL. I don't know why they couldn't produce slightly superior thing. I mean, I think that was a failing in our policy, I think. Our policy would have been to produce an aircraft in HAL. And they were capable of doing it.
Here we'll take a short break. When we return, we continue our conversation with the only Marshal of the Indian Air Force, Arjun Singh. Welcome back. We are in conversation with the Marshal of the Indian Air Force, Arjun Singh. Sir, in 1971, you were appointed the ambassador to Switzerland and later to Kenya. How was that experience?
Well, it's a different kind of life. People used to take these jobs as social things. Party, this and so on. My experience was it really that you have to deal in the country to which you accredited to. Now, supposing I'm in Switzerland, I'm really concerned with Switzerland primarily, and so on. If you start imagining that you're there to establish relations between Argentina and India, you're making a great mistake. Now, I really dealt with that. Swiss are very liable people, and so are Kenyans.
You're also a member of the Minorities Commission. Do you think the lot of the minorities is any better now? Because some people feel that the Muslims, even today, feel quite marginalized in the Indian social milieu.
Now, first of all, I tell you that there has never been, and I hope never would be, communalism in the Air Force or the Army. That is very important. A Muslim should not think that he will be done down. In our case, as you know, one of our chiefs is a Muslim. When our relation with Pakistan is very tense. So that's a face, you see, we have. Now that is that's imagination of people. It's a fact that Muslims suffer educationally. More than half the people, Muslim, study in madrasas. The standard of madrasa is that to learn by heart much of the Quran. So in doing any service in the country, that's not helpful.
Talking of the 1984 anti-Sikh violence, where were you at that point of time and how did you feel?
I was here. I view 84 riots in a different way. First of all, the Sikhs had killed Indira Gandhi. Now that automatically in people's mind puts blame on the whole Sikh community. We may not think though, but public will think that, you see. Now that was, I don't know, it was the most stupid act I think anybody could think of. And it ultimately appeared, of course they were hanged, it was purely a family affair, you know, a very small group of people got together who decided all that. Now that is, I think, you know, luckily all the Sikhs condemned this very thoroughly.
Later you were the lieutenant governor of Delhi, though even only for a brief time. Did you try and check as to what really happened in November 84 and who was responsible?
Well, in all these things, my experience was also that we had a lot of inquiries and so on, nothing really came out. See, if people, well-to-do people and not so well-to-do people live side by side, when some kind of incidents like occur, the desire of the people to have not is try to steal things. It was a government failure, no doubt. When this sort of thing is about to happen, even a few shots in the air, up in the air, will have effect. Now that is where the government is to blame, because the direction of the government was not decisive.
Why did you resign as the lieutenant governor of Delhi?
I didn't resign. The government changed and they gave me the option. And they said, no, well, Chandrasekhar became the prime minister. And Chandrasekhar and I, in life, had never really got on too well. So the president spoke with me. President himself, Venkataraman, personally. He said, the Prime Minister is not very happy. And I said, no. I said, I'm absolutely prepared to go. And then I sent him a letter within about half an hour. Said, I hereby resign, Mother. Without giving any reason.
Sir, many years after you retired, you were made the Marshal of the Indian Air Force. Did that come as a surprise?
I don't know. I don't know how it happened, really. I don't know. It's, very difficult. I don't know who initiated it. See, Vajpayee was the Prime Minister at that time. And I don't know up to now who initiated the whole. Somebody got to initiate. And I don't know. Nobody given me that information.
So the Army and the Air Force today seem to disagree on a lot of things. Was it the same in your time?
Absolutely the same. All human beings. We're bound to agree. Bound to agree on things, bound to disagree on something. And you people always give more prominence to where disagreement comes in. See, agreement is no news. Disagreement is news. So that is what happened. But there is never complete agreement on all subjects amongst the chiefs of staff. Now I was there 5.5 years. And I was also chairman of the committee for somewhere around 4 years. Now, you can't, you either accept or you can approach the government.
Sir, talking of the family, in the Air Force, the couple of Mr. and Mrs. Arjun Singh was legendary. Can you tell our viewers how you met the young lady who was to become your wife later?
Was a long time ago. We met very early, but that's all.
Mrs. Teji Singh was a part of your struggles and your triumphs. So life without her must be hard.
You can well imagine.
Sir, talking of other things, you've been a fitness freak. You're fond of cycling, you're fond of walking, you're fond of golfing. So how do you keep fit now?
No, but cycling I can't do now, you know, because I have leg trouble. And I play golf. I try to do 3 times a week. But then, you see, walking is a difficulty, but playing is not difficulty. So I go in the court, play golf now regularly, played yesterday, and I play tomorrow again, I think.
So you still look quite fit, touch wood. So do you fit into some of the uniforms that you wore when you were in active service?
Same, I never change uniform. And I can tell you now, my my weight from my college days is only about 2 or 3 kilograms more. Otherwise the same. I got some old shoes which fit me thoroughly. And by the way, this is about 35 years old. What were they?
That's very interesting. A khori feeling
even
heavy, not, sir, to see.
Even now, I'm wearing no bills. just.
ਇੱਕ ਹੋਰ ਵੀ ਫੀਲਿੰਗ ਹੈਗੀ ਕਿ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਵੈਸੇ ਤਾਂ ਏਅਰ ਫੋਰਸ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਬੜੇ ਵੱਡੇ ਅਹੁਦੇ ਤੇ ਪਹੁੰਚੇ ਪਰ ਫਿਰ ਵੀ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਐਟ ਹਾਰਟ ਯੂ ਆਰ ਸਟਿਲ ਅ ਜੱਟ ਸੋ ਕਦੀ ਕਦੀ ਜੀ ਕਰਦਾ ਵਾ ਫਾਰਮ ਦੇ ਉੱਤੇ ਜਾ ਕੇ ਫਾਰਮਿੰਗ ਕਰਨ ਨੂੰ ਜਾਂ ਵਾਈ ਕਰ
ਬਾਈ ਬਾਈ ਯੂ ਸੀ ਆਈ ਹੈਵ ਨੋ ਲੈਂਡ ਨਾਓ ਐਂਡ ਮੈਨੀ ਮਾਈ ਰਿਲੇਸ਼ਨਸ ਹੂ ਲੈਂਡ ਨਾਓ ਦੇ ਸੇ ਦੈਟ ਆਮ ਨੋ ਜੱਟ ਸੋ ਦੀ ਲੈਂਡ ਇਜ਼ ਵੈਰੀ ਵੈਰੀ ਡੀਅਰ ਟੂ ਅ ਜੱਟ And I had a lot of land at one time.
But you had a farm close to Delhi, no?
I had only, that was only 7 acres. I sold that and I gave to a trust for the Air Force.
As a father figure of the defense services, what is the advice you would give to the young officers of today?
Basically nothing, I think it's well done. Got good commanders, good I mean, his achievements are, well, it's dealing primarily with much better environment, more technical, more. But basically, it's the same. You see, the basic never changed in the service.
Has somebody from the family joined the defense services after you did, sir?
Later on, there was a stage where the senior officer's sons, In all the three services, didn't want their children's sons to go into them, where the conditions were not very favorable. See, you got to compare always the conditions of the services with the conditions of professional lives. Now, for example, if nothing else, at least the IES. So that's, see, if that IES also, people stopped coming at one time. Because the conditions are very low. So now it's probably picking up, I think. I can't tell.
So your son never joined the Army or the Air Force?
No senior officer's son. Air Marshal Mukherjee's son didn't join. Engineer's son didn't join. They were Pratap Lal Singh didn't join. All the people I can remember now. And the president also. I don't think Tyagi had... has anybody in the Air Force. No, that is also that, see, straight away, people, if he's good, people say it because of his father, influence. Mm. If he's not good, he say, by God, what a shame. He's not like, so this, these are things which act on people's minds.
Thank you very much for speaking to us, sir. May I have the privilege of shaking my hand with
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
With that, we end this edition of Fair and Square. We were in conversation with the Marshal of the Indian Air Force, Arjun Singh. Thank you for watching.